Philippine Transport Security Administrator Mau Aplasca, meanwhile, steps down following calls for his resignation. A copy of his resignation letter was obtained by ABS-CBN News. Aplasca earlier went on voluntary leave following the viral theft case in Naia. Aplasca insists he has done nothing wrong and had done his best to cleanse the ranks of the Transport Security Office. House Speaker Martin Romualdez had threatened to block the 2024 budget of Aplasca's office if he did not step down. Four employees of the Office of Transportation Security found guilty of stealing in a probe conducted by the Transportation Department. The four include the viral female security personnel who was caught on video swallowing a passenger's missing money worth $300. They have been suspended and might face dismissal from service. A criminal investigation would also take place to determine if there were other personnel involved.
Ang sinasabi doon sa investigasyon ay guilty.
Guilty na.
Guilty na pera.
Although ang sinasabi nga nung babae, no, chocolate daw. Meron siyang affidavit. Pero ang nakita ng mga investigador ay guilty siya. Dapat kasi yung nakita natin dito sa, yung nakita talaga na may mga ginagawa, no? Doon sa CCTV. No? But siguro pag nagkaroon ng criminal investigation, ilalabas pa kung meron pang other people involved.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. rejects a proposal to reduce rice tariff imports on imported rice. Marcos says it is not the right time to lower tariffs yet, but global rice prices seem to go down. His decision was announced after a sectoral meeting in the palace, where Philippine economic managers and several government agencies presented updates on the proposed rice tariff reduction. Marcos adds, his executive order 39 that put caps on rice prices will remain in effect for now. Fuel subsidies to public utility vehicle drivers set to face a 500 million peso budget cut next year. The Transportation Department initially requested a 5 billion peso fund for fuel subsidies, but the Budget Department only granted half of the amount, citing a limited fiscal space. Lawmakers are backing increased funding for the program.
Hindi katanggap-tanggap ang cut sa fuel subsidy. Dahil, Mr. Speaker, while may ganung mga cuts, ang ating economic managers naman ayaw dun sa suspension or removal ng VAT and train excise tax sa fuel.
Ito yung panahon para talagang magbigay importansya ka ng direktang subsidya para sa ating transport sector. Sana, no? Imbis na confidential funds na lang natin natin nilalagay yung pondo natin, lagay naman natin dito sa mga direktang mapapakinabangan o subsidy talaga para sa ating mga super, sa ating mga sa ating transport sector.
The subsidies are being distributed to PUV drivers as local pump prices hit nearly 70 pesos per liter. House lawmakers are also calling on major oil companies to give fuel discounts to motorists.
Ang pakiusap na lang namin ngayon ng Kongreso, dagdagan ninyo yung discount sa pinamimigay ninyo Big Three. Baka kung pwede nyo doblehin o dagdagan pa ng piso, dalawang piso sa mga discounts. Tapos baka pwede isama nyo na yung private sector, yung mga may sasakyan. Kasi hindi naman lahat ng tao nagko-commute.
Manila's top diplomat justifies the removal of floating barriers installed by China in Scarborough Shoal. Foreign Affairs Secretary Enrique Manalo says the move is consistent with the position of the Philippines in protecting its territorial rights. As for proposals to file a new case against China before an international tribunal, Manalo says the DFA still needs to study the procedures. He insists Manila and Beijing must settle their issues diplomatically.
We had a right to practice our sovereignty and our sovereign rights.
We both recognize that we have differences in the South China Sea. But long ago, we already said that we will not make that the only factor in our relationship with China. But nevertheless, it's a difference. And we have agreed to manage it. And so the challenge is how to manage it properly.
The Philippines is also seeking to secure a seat in the United Nations Security Council. Manalo says it would give the country a stronger voice in countering China's aggression in the West Philippine Sea. China, meanwhile, issues a stern warning to the Philippines. Beijing says Manila must not make any provocations or seek trouble in the South China Sea. China's statement came a day after the removal of its 14 barrier in Scarborough Shoal, which was meant to block Filipino fishermen. Scarborough Shoal is located within the exclusive economic zone of the Philippines, but China has a constant presence there. The 2016 arbitral victory of the Philippines has already invalidated Beijing's sweeping claims in the South China Sea. Overseas, U.S. President Joe Biden joins a picket line with striking car workers in Michigan, a first by a sitting U.S. president. He's backing their call for a 40% pay raise, telling him they deserve a lot more than what they're getting.
The fact of the matter is that you guys, the UAW, you saved the automobile industry back in 2008 and before. Made a lot of sacrifices, gave up a lot, and the companies were in trouble. But now they're doing incredibly well. And guess what? You should be doing incredibly well, too.
Biden's appearance on the strike comes a day before former U.S. President Donald Trump speaks to auto workers in the state. The rare back-to-back events highlight the importance of union support in the 2024 presidential election. The United Auto Workers has declined to support any candidate in next year's race for the White House, making it the only major union not to back Biden.